Hello everyone, check it out, another new game. This is Sproggiwood. It just came out on Steam yesterday or 2 days ago, whatever. As it calls itself, it is a story-driven, turn-based roguelike set in the humorous world of Finnish mythology. I've played it for like a little bit, just like a minute or two. I think it's pretty cool. I just want to give it a go, see what it's like. Let's try normal difficulty. There was once an island called Clog, where clogheads chased sheep through the fog. They laughed on the double and never made trouble until they met Sproggy of Sprog. Classic. Classic rhyme. talking sheep, look, over there, or over here, a cloghead sleeps. So I see. Anyway, my work here is done. The rest is up to you. Thank you, Rocco. By the power you've granted me, I will save my realm, if you say so. Look, the cloghead awakens. Away, away, before it sees you. Hey, you, with the pitchfork. Yes, you, cloghead. Are you surprised to meet a talking sheep? Why don't you take a closer look? It's a sheep, and it's talking. I told you. Now, follow me. I want to show you something marvelous. Oh no, a yellow jelly. It's going to eat us. We are doomed. It's hopeless, Cloghead. Let us lie down and accept our fates. Bam! You're brave, Cloghead. You saved us from that deadly, adorable jelly. I don't know why I suddenly have an accent for this. Yikes, another jelly. This one is twice as big, twice as cute. Bam! Level up. Okay, choose a power to upgrade. What I did before was the pitchfork, because it looked like the most fun. Cloghead, you look wiser now, as if you've learned something from the experience of fighting those jellies. Take a look at your new power. Bam. Yeah, so hurl a pitchfork in a direction at an enemy. It's pretty beastly. I used it once. Powers cost stamina, and it looks like killing those jellies gave you stamina stars. Okay. Oh no, what is that? Don't touch it. On second thought, touch it. I picked up a flaming shovel. My old one, keep pokes things. New one shoots a pillar of flame that deals 4 to 6 damage. That sounds better. Cloghead, take a look at your weapon.
Nice.
I'm also equipped with a simple pair of dungarees. How mighty you are to behold, Cloghead, a true adventurer. Wait, Cloghead, if you walk up to that jelly, it'll bite you again. Can you outsmart it? If you can wait a turn, it'll come to you. Click the hourglass or press space. Space. Can I move? Oh, I can use the D-pad. Or wads. Yes, you outsmarted a jelly cube, and you taught it a deadly lesson for being so adorable. Alright. We are off to the races. Look, this is what I want you to want to show you, a mysterious door. Let's enter it heedlessly. I agree. Whoa, oh, that was loud. Look, Cloghead, we are transported to a wonderful place. The rivers are so blue, the forests are so green, but I must confess something. I fooled you, I'm no sheep, no sheep at all. Hark, mortal, it's a Sproggy. I am Sproggy, Dark Lord of this realm. Begin your life anew as my thrall, for I am now your master. You will spend the remainder of your days in my realm, Sprog, toiling as I see fit. Now let us visit the meager peasant village where you live. Oh, that's actually hurting my throat. Whew. So you don't succumb to feeling of despair, I built this quaint farm and cottage for you. Lovely, aren't they? Now, my thrall, it is time to test your mettle. It is time to put you to work. Ooh, need some water. For your first task, you must quell the uprising of a troublesome jelly lord. His name is Big Ick, and he lives at the bottom of a cave called Iggikolo. Big Ick fancies himself something of a social philosopher. Lately he's been stirring up dissent among the jellies, trying to convince them to organize into solid forms. I will not have it. You must go to Iggikolo and put Big Ick in his place.
Ooh, what can I do here? Nothing. Shop. I don't have any gold. Okay, cool. Let's take on Bicky Ick. Iggikolo. Yep, yeah, alright. Well, apparently there's other classes, but I only have one.
It is time to do my bidding, Cloghead. Remember what you learned about defending yourself when I wore that ridiculous sheep costume. Now go!
I think I'm gonna like this game. Alright. see what we got here. So yes, let's take what we've learned. Bam! Alright. Okay. Oh! Oh! Alright. Maybe I can. Yes. Oh no, I don't have a spell anymore. Oh, apparently you level up every time. Damn it. Yeah, I don't have a spell. Crud! Oh wait, but I did level up. Okay, so I see. So it seems to me... Sorry, is this loud? It seems loud. Oh, it went up again. You jerk! That's what I had it up before. It seems to me like the overworld is maybe like your home base, something you go to every time. Maybe you can unlock things, whereas when you're in here, it's individual. This looks suspicious. Alright. You know, it's a one-time thing. Oh! Oh, it took a turn. Frost Shovel Barb. Shoots a frost barb that deals 1 to 2 damage and freezes enemies for one turn. Works once per enemy. I'm assuming that's more powerful. Ah, it's available in the shop. Okay, cool. Let's attack this thing. Boom! Yeah! Ugh! And I'll wait, and then blast ya! Aw, yeah. No, let's head back here. Let's be tactical about this. Ugh! Wait. Ugh! Huh. No! Oh, crap! Alright, let's wait for it to come to me. Bam! So the big ones split up. Oh, there's another... Is this... Alright, I'll wait. Bam! No! Bam! Bam! Alright, I have taken a lot of damage. I need to be careful about this. It seems I'm too casual, I think. Alright, here we go. Oh, yes. Health potion. Nice. Bam! Aw, yeah. Woo! No sweat. Alright, what can I do now? Pumpkin bomb. Plant a bomb with an adjacent space that explodes when an enemy steps on it. That sounds pretty handy. Or the scarecrow. Scare enemy away for 3 turns. That seems more tactical. That seems like a good idea. Alright. Oh. Come here. Bam! Bam! You're gonna split up into smaller ones? I'm gonna wait for you? Oh yeah. See that? Those are tactics, my friend. I'm gonna wait a turn. And I know there's another one. Oh, he left it. He went away. Oh yeah. No sweat. All right, wait a turn. Oh yeah. Ooh, dungarees. Oh, I didn't see what the other one was. 30% chance to ignore an attack and teleport you to a random space. That sounds dangerous as hell. Vanishing dungarees. Nice. But I'm gonna equip them. Oh, shoot. Ow. Dang it. Anything under here? Yeah. More coins. Alright. I don't trust this thing. Oh! I took a hit. Oh no. Okay, I'm gonna wait here. Funnel them in. And then hopefully... Yes! Okay. Oh no! It's a big one. Oh, I should probably take a potion. Restores to full health. Yes, I was very low. I'm gonna wait for you to come to me. You got bigger. No, no. Man, these guys are dastardly. Oh my god, does he just... Like... Oh no, what did I do that for? Oh, this is a bad idea. Oh, do you just non-stop create? Alright, let's hit 4. Yeah, make a scarecrow that will... Yeah, hopefully I can lose these guys. Unless that's the king guy I need to take out. Oh, that would be bad. Oh no. Oh, this is bad. I'm in a bad spot right now. Oh god, I've woken up another one. Alright, you know what I gotta do? Okay, cool. I'm gonna use... Nope. What? I'm gonna use two. And hit this way. No! I don't know what to do about this. This seems too hard. I'm in a rough spot. Oh no. Oh shoot. Yeah, this ain't good. This ain't good at all. Okay, if I hit four... Maybe I can convince them all to come in here? This just seems like a losing cause, though. If I hit two... Bam! Is there anything I can do about this, though? It just doesn't seem like it, right? I'm not stupid. I am leveling up. Oh! We could use these stuff to get away. This looks like a thing. Oh, I should probably level up. what can I do? I'm gonna upgrade Pitchfork again. Okay, I'm at Big Ix Lair. And I can see that there's something up here, according to the minimap. There he is! Don't fall for his persuasive rhetoric! Gribble, 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 gribble! Alright, I'm gonna lure him around this corner. Oh, he's big. No. Yes! No, okay, corner is probably a bad idea. So hit two again. Boom. Oh god, no. Ah! That was dumb of me. Alright, I need to try this again. I'll be right back. Okay, here we go again. The only thing I picked up differently was... this spell right here. Shoots a big fireball in a chosen direction. Bam! Alright, I feel like I need to funnel him somewhere. Uh-oh. Yes! I took him out! Mysterious mushroom. Eep! Oh no! It ran away! And what is this? A door. Ah, excellent! I made it! A new villager? New villager? Oh, nice! Class reward. Loot from jars, leaves, monsters. Excellent! You did it! Excellent work, Cloghead! Go to Icky Colo and put Big Ick in his place. Yes! What's that? Something about a mushroom? First, let us examine the spoils you recovered from Big Ick's lair. Oh my god! Okay. I can choose one. Woodmill, I get to be an archer. Or a forge, I get to be a warrior. Warrior. Yes, Cloghead! Your simple, dull civilization is expanding. Now you can send warriors on adventures. And each time you beat an old dungeon with a new class, you'll loot 1,000 more gold. Now tell me about this mushroom. It popped out of Big Ick? New species in Sproggiwood? Oh, yippee yay yo! I mean, rejoice another creature for me to subjugate! Oh, who am I kidding? I'm no Dark Lord, I'm just Sproggy, a little guardian spirit who wants to save his realm from ruin. I'm sorry about all those terrible things I said to you. Let me explain. This is Sprog, my realm. Well, not mine technically, I didn't create it, but I am its guardian spirit. Anyway, Sprog is populated with some wonderful creatures, but there is no order, no community. With enough time, the denizens of Sprog will ravish each other, and leave nothing but destruction and chaos in their wake. How can I be certain of this, you ask? You must trust me, Cloghead, for I know things most spirits do not. I am thirsty. That's where you come in. I've been spying on, admiring your people for some time. The Clogheads value peace, order, and civility, and you thrive accordingly. And so it hit me. The answer to Sprog's problems is civilization. And you can bring civilization to Sprog. You see, Cloghead, this is why I kidnapped or guided you to Sprog. Now I'm going to investigate this curious mushroom. In the meantime, meet Spencer Squish. I relocated him here from Ikikolo so that he could help you around your village. Spencer, explain how the Clogheads should spend their gold. I'll be back with news about that mushroom. Whew. With all that shiny gold, you won a fair and square. You can buy things in town. Ooh, a shop. Oh, pardon me. You can buy civic boosts to improve your civilization. Or gear that you find in dungeons. You may have noticed that dungeon gear dematerializes when you leave a dungeon through a portal. Traveling through the astral plane has its cost. But once you buy gear at the shop, you'll keep it for good. Okay, pretty cool. You can also buy potions and scrolls you find in dungeons. Once you can buy a potion or scroll, you can take it with you every time you go adventuring. And that, Squish, is that. Squish, squish. Bye. Okay, that's pretty cool. Huh, so, gain experience faster, that's a pretty good one. Items cost less. Now, merchant, would that be in here? Probably not. Find more cryptic shrines, more special vases. Okay, that'd be pretty handy. Flaming shovel, frost barb shovel. Frost barb web was pretty handy, I must admit. What do these do? Yeah. Oh, it's just 20 and 30%. And then potions. Health potion would probably be a good one to have. Let's buy that. So I always have that. That would be handy. And storage. Mail, sword. Suit of heavy armor. Not very long. I just bought consumables, didn't I? Yeah. Yeah, storage. Okay, well, whatever. We'll figure it out. But just looking at the time, I don't think I have enough time to start another place. This will be a little bit of an introductory episode. I hope everyone's enjoying it. I sure am. I think this game's going to be a lot of fun. But that will be it for me today, so thanks everyone for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day. Bye-bye!